this is the first step of the kitchen remodel. Starting the kitchen. Oh, I got my plans laid out. So this is a relatively simple kitchen. It's not a small kitchen, but it makes an L shape. This is the top view here. So it's got kind of a tight corner in here, and the stove had to fit in that corner, and that was the most difficult part of this design and layout, is to make that corner work. But anyways, starting this job, it's got like 30 some doors, glass doors on top. It's got 9-foot ceilings, so I'm doing, you know, 2 doors on the upper cabinets. It's going to be a white painted finish, and the interiors are going to be painted, so there's going to be a lot of painting, a lot of white. I've got poplar for the doors, poplar plywood to make all the cabinets. Some of this kind of got a little wanky in here, got pretty dry. I don't know. I'm just going to start making some cuts. So my first cuts with the poplar were to make the door stock, which will be resized and replaned later on. I do this ahead of time so that I can give the wood time to acclimate inside the shop and become more stable so that I can select better material for making stable doors. Factory edges on plywood are seldomly perfectly straight or square, so in order to get the accuracy that I need to make perfectly square cabinets, I need to construct a jig for straightening and squaring plywood parts before I make the finished cuts on the table saw. So instead of buying a $15,000 sliding table saw, I constructed a relatively simple but large jig that involves straight edges and a flush trimming pattern router bit. I'm going to make a very simple hole drilling jig for adjustable shelves in kitchen cabinets. These are my interior walls for my lower cabinets, so I'm ready to bore the holes for the adjustable shelves before I put the cabinets together. This is what they look like. So I'm going to drill the holes and then paint the interiors, and then I install these grommets as the last step for a more finished appearance. I start from the bottom about 5 inches up, so I have to calculate the spacing that I need to clear the hinges. For lower cabinets, I set it back about 3 inches from the inside of the face frame, and then for the upper cabinets, I set it back 2 inches. Thank you. So jumping ahead and skipping some steps due to an unfortunate SD card error, here's what we missed. I made and installed this finished exposed panel on the one lower cabinet, added another piece onto the face frame of the other cabinet. I cut the quarter inch plywood backs for all the lower cabinets, which will be painted separately and added on later. I made the solid wood baseboard for the toe kick, which will also be painted separately. And I also made the rest of the parts to make the finished panels on the upper cabinets. And this was done on the router table. And there will be more of this type of setup later on, so it's not a critical step that was missed. So continuing, here I'm making plywood rips to build the toe kicks. The toe kicks are made separately from the lower base cabinets, and they will be the first things installed on site. The toe kicks are carefully leveled and fastened to the floor, then the lower base cabinets are installed on top.
white.
They help you see better, like progressive eyeglasses or multifocal contacts. Learn more at your yearly comprehensive eye exam.
So, moving on with the kitchen job, I'm now ready to start making doors and drawer boxes. I'm going to make the drawer boxes out of this pine. And I already installed my lower cabinets. I had to get that part of the job first because the countertops are going to be stone. So I had to coordinate the schedule with the stone guys, because they had to come in and make their templates. So I just got the empty cabinet boxes installed in place for the lower cabinets. And typically you would make all the doors and fit them on before you install them, but you don't actually have to do it that way. As long as you know the exact measurements of all those openings and that they're square, you can just make square door fronts and drawer fronts, and if your math is right, they'll all fit when you install them. So that's what I'm hoping for. I made this story stick, which is going to be my reference for all the measurements of all the fronts and doors that are going to go on. And I use this 3/32 shim as the spacer for the reveals. So I draw the reveals on for each door to get the spacing right. So just as a note, these measurements that I have on this drawing are just approximations. They don't actually represent the finished dimensions of the cabinetry. The way I do this layout is with 3/4-inch plywood, but the plywood is actually closer to 11/16, and that actually throws off the spacing. And I actually cut a few things undersized just in case I needed extra room. So everything ended up as a different dimension. So I don't actually use any of these numbers on here when I do the fronts. I just use it as an approximation. There was a belly in the wall in this area right here, and that threw off the installation of the other cabinet on the other side of this corner. Kind of made everything a little bit tight in there, and I had to trim the face frame opening a little bit to get the stove to fit in. And all these other sticks I have here are the spacer sticks that I use to actually build the cabinets and the face frames. So these are all marked together and labeled. So I can reference these actual dimensions if I need to get a calculation for the exact opening of what those face frames ended up being. So I don't actually have to rely on taking measurements, which could have a margin of error. These are the actual spacers that were used to assemble the face frames and the interior of the cabinets. That's where the accuracy pays off. If you can make a cabinet that's, you know, very evenly spaced and perfectly square, it'll save time because it makes the math easier. And yeah, so now it's time to build some stuff. I'm going to start with the drawer boxes. Thank you. Okay, so I made another drawing of the exact size of the doors. So I will use these numbers to generate the cut list to make the frame and panel door parts.
Thank you.